Regents wants to freeze tuition at three public universities in the state, and Angie Hunt is in our Ames Live Link tonight. Boy, Angie, after years of increases, some of them pretty big, how can this be possible?
Well, there are a couple of factors at work, Kevin. One, enrollment numbers have certainly helped. There are more students on campus at Iowa and Iowa State, so more tuition dollars coming in. There's also support from university leaders. It was actually University of Iowa President Sally Mason who suggested the tuition freeze.
As we looked at the budget, it became apparent to me that one of the things we could do immediately to alleviate some of the pressure, especially on our resident students and their families, was to not raise tuition.
Now, there is a bit of a catch to this tuition freeze. Board of Regents President Craig Lang says they won't raise tuition as long as the Iowa legislature approves its funding request. The board is asking state lawmakers for a 2.6% increase in funding. Lang says they want to send a message to the legislature that it's important to keep education affordable for Iowa students. One way universities have helped make college affordable is through tuition set aside, and that was an issue also discussed at today's meeting. The Regents want to take a completely new approach and use state dollars to provide scholarships and need-based grants to Iowa students.
Abandon the idea that we're taking scholarship money or taking money from tuition and then redistributing it back to students, even though that's a practice that happens in every public university across the country.
Now, the Regents are asking lawmakers for just over $39 million over the course of about 5 years. That would be strictly for scholarships and money in addition to their appropriations requests that they are making. Now, whatever the state would allocate, the Regents say they would then reduce that same amount for tuition. So, say, for example, they got the full $39 million, they would then reduce that in tuition. That's about $1,000 per student. Now, the board did not take any action on this issue. They do want to get public comment and discuss this again in October.
That's a promising looking idea.